Now, I've got to change tack a little bit. We've been talking about the weather a lot, and I'm a little bit nervy now because I'm not totally sure what I'm supposed to be doing, but I can say good morning to Harry Chanter. Morning, Harry.
Good morning.
You've just walked in the studio while we were doing our snow chat.
I have, yes.
With your ukuleles.
Yes.
From the Plymouth Ukulele Players.
The Plymouth Ukulele Club, mm-hmm, is the main group.
Mm-hmm.
That's a Tuesday night. Anyone can come along.
Okay.
And there's about 50 people come along most Tuesdays.
Okay.
And then we've got two groups that go out into pubs and clubs gigging and earning money for charity. So I'm one of the... I am the founder member of the Plymouth Ukulele Club.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a member of the Plymouth Ukulele Players, which, yeah, is the younger group of people that entertain people in pubs and clubs. We also have the Queen's Dock Ukulele Players, which primarily are all from our club as well, but they're primarily all retired. So they do a lot more gigs than we do.
Okay, well, I'm going to just read something word for word. The UK's biggest celebration of creativity has begun. It's the Get Creative Festival 2018, and it's on all this week with more than 1,200 events at getcreativeuk.com and programmes here on the BBC as well. Now, each day this week, we're going to try and do something different at breakfast. I'd need your suggestions as well. So perhaps you've got a talent. You can come and teach me something new one day this week. If so, would love for you to get in touch. You can call 0345 301 1034. What's your secret talent today? Harry is going to teach me how to play the ukulele. First of all, we haven't got long, so how easy is this?
Very easy. It's to play the ukulele is very easy. To play it well is a bit more difficult.
Right.
Very easy.
Harry, I don't even know. Is this, what I have in my hand, is this a ukulele?
That is a ukulele, yes.
Because I've had this for years. A friend of mine bought it for me.
Right.
And it's just been sitting on a shelf looking pretty.
I hope it's tuned.
Oh, I don't. Put it this way. Nowadays.
It's not, is it? No.
Nowadays, my four-year-old likes to play
right.
with it.
Okay.
So I wouldn't have a clue
right.
how to tune it.
Okay.
I'm left-handed as well. I'm getting all the excuses.
Oh, dear.
In. So right. I'm left-handed as well. So I don't really know how to hold it.
Right. Well, if you've never played a ukulele before, some left-handed players play left-handed. Some left-handed players play the normal way round. Because if you've never...
Then what are you saying? That being left-handed is not normal, Harry?
Not well, we have a number of left-handed players in our club.
Yeah.
And some play the right way round, some play left-handed. So if you've never picked the ukulele up before, you might not know what way is the right way for you.
Okay.
Until you pick it up and start strumming, so to speak.
So are you able to teach me something right now?
Well, I've got my ukulele here. So a C chord, which is one of the bass chords. A C chord is very simple. It's a one finger on the bottom string. You throw me a bit being a left-hander, mind.
But it's good because we're mirroring each
yes.
other.
It's your ring finger
right.
on the third fret of the bottom string, and
yeah.
that will give you a C. Not on that ukulele one, because it's completely out of tune.
Oh, can you do anything about that?
Probably not instantly, not in the next few minutes.
All right, but, let's go for that.
Right, so, well, that would be a C. That would be a C. And the thing with the ukulele...
Do not adjust your radios.
No, so if that's a C, and the next chord that you'd learn to play after that one would be an A minor. Now, an A minor, you lift off your ring finger
yeah.
off the fret that you had it on, and you
yeah.
put your middle finger
yeah.
on the top string.
Yeah.
On the
I don't
second
think my fingers
fret.
Are big enough for all this. Okay.
Yeah, they will be. Yeah. And then you've got A minor... If yours was in tune, that would be A minor.
So it sounds all right to me, Harry.
And it's okay. It's a good start. And then what you've got two chords as a progression. You've got C and A minor. So that's a chord progression.
Oh, I'm supposed to move my...
It's muscle memory, it's called. You know, you'll get to know if you start playing, and if you've got a four-year-old daughter, the best thing to do is to learn to play the ukulele with her. Because she learned a lot faster than you, of course.
If you're sitting in your Campton Rest Centre at the moment, hopefully this is bringing you some light relief. So when can we play, like, I don't know, something by Queen or ABBA?
Not by Queen or ABBA, no.
Can you give us a little tinkle?
Right, well, I'm not a good singer. I did say that to the producer, but he said, that's okay, that's fine. So I'll do... Teenage Kicks, so I'll do a few bars of it anyway.
Are there any naughty words?
Right. Hang on. Teenage dreams are hard to beat. Every time she walks down the street, another girl in the neighborhood. She was mine, she looked so good. Wanna hold her tight. Get teenage kicks right through the night. And so forth.
Oh, Harry, well, so when can I play that?
Well, to be honest, that is a very easy chord sequence to learn.
So by tomorrow, I'll be all right.
You can't learn anything instantly. It takes time. I learned everything on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
And because when I started 5-6 years ago, there was no one else in Plymouth that I knew that either had a ukulele or played a ukulele.
So it's a bit of a growing trend, then.
Oh, it's in the last 7 years, it's just got massive. So now there's other people you can learn from, but yeah. I learned everything on YouTube.
And you said about 5 or 6 years ago.
I started the Plymouth Ukulele Club about then, 6 years ago, I would say. I made a Facebook page called Who Can Play the Ukulele in Plymouth? And yeah. About 7 or 8 people joined. And from that 7 or 8 people, we all met in a pub one day. We all met in a pub one day and strummed away. And that has grown now into 50 people in the club that come most Tuesdays now.
Wow, okay, so it's a growing trend. We'll all be doing it by Friday. Thank you very much,
that's
Harry.
That's all right, fine. Thank you
Harry
very much.
Harry Chanter speaking to us today.
Can I just say, yeah. As a group, the entire group, we've earned about £12,000 or more for local charities in the last 3 years. So we do it for fun, you know, we don't charge anyone, we just ask for a charitable donation. And we shake our tins. We played in the Woodside on Saturday and we made altogether £280 for charity.
Well done.
That was a £200 donation from the landlord and we shook our tins and people put the money in.
Thank you. Harry speaking to us today, all part of the Get Creative Festival, which is on all this week. There are some programmes here on the BBC and you can get all the details of the events at getcreativeuk.com as well. And as I said a moment ago, I'd like your suggestions, something you can teach me one day this week. We've started with the ukulele, all right, mine wasn't in tune. That was the only issue I had. Otherwise, I'd have been perfect. So what can you teach me this week? Get in touch. You can text 81333. Start your message with the word Devon or call us 03 345 301 1034. Should have played that on the ukulele, that little intro. James has got the news headlines.
That would have been impressive. The return of the